Watch this video.
It's warming. It's heartwarming to see to have like all the old memories come back of working with my old colleagues at Cedar Lake. And yeah, and I also see things like, you know, after you've had a little bit more experience, things I would like to do differently. But yeah. How is it for you to see that?
For me, this is like the epitome of dance. I remember like growing up and watching this and being so excited and like seeing people that look like me and seeing someone that like I related to in a very different way than most dancers at the time. Mm. So watching this now, it's like a, like, whoa, I'm like finally doing this, like something that I grew up watching and always admired. And cool. Yeah, cool. So it's like a little heartwarming too. I'm Ricardo Hartley III. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I am a graduate of the Juilliard School, and this is my second season with NDT too.
I'm Jon Bond. I'm originally from Orange County, California, and this is my eighth season with NDT One. Prior to coming here, I danced in New York with the Dance Theater of Harlem, Dancing Through Barriers Ensemble, and later Cedar Lake Contemporary Ballet, where I got to work with many European choreographers, some of which I work with here now as well, and then Crystal Pite, as we are gonna speak about. One of our associate choreographers was also our associate choreographer at Cedar Lake, and that's where this piece, Ten Duets on a Theme of Rescue, all came from, 2008.
Perfect. That was great. That was good.
Bah!
Could you introduce the work to us and tell us a little bit about it?
So we are performing Ten Duets on a Theme of Rescue by Crystal Pite. And this piece consists of many duets that have this theme of rescue and this theme of support between each of the individuals that are in the piece. And I think each pair has a different way of supporting one another, in a different way of expressing like longing for something, or retracting from each other, or this like need to be with one another, or need to be separate from each other. And I think it hits all the boxes also, and it's like what connects us as humans, and like this overarching theme of like human nature. And I think this piece encapsulates all of that. Yeah. Jon, could you elaborate on the original creation process for this piece?
It was my second season with Cedar Lake when we created this. Not too many of us, I think, knew much about Crystal at the time. It was super intimate. Like many creations, we all started in the group, and she actually taught a phrase to Back to Black. That's how we learned, actually, what is that? Don't something, this phrase. Right, Amy Winehouse. And from there, just, I don't know, it just kind of took off, and she was really, really humble and sweet and there with each one of us, left a lot of room to play. Her wording, her insight to her movement and what she was striving for and trying to get out of each one of us personally was something really beautiful to see and work with for the first ish time in my career. Yeah. I remember she was really inspired by Solaris, the movie, which is where the music comes from. And I thought I had watched it actually back then, but apparently I didn't. I went to go check it out recently to prepare for this. And it is a really beautiful movie. And I think not only was she inspired by the music and whatnot, but like looking at the film, the cinematic aspect of it, and the lighting and everything, I think I saw many similarities, at least. Or maybe I'm connecting my own dots, I don't know, but yeah. Speaking about my experience with Crystal in the studio, how are you experiencing the process so far? And Does restaging the work create different obstacles and responsibilities?
Yeah. It's been incredible, to say the least. Also just extremely inspiring to step into this role. I think this role and this piece has so much legacy around it, and it's one of the like iconic Crystal pieces that for me, I always like always wanted to perform and always wanted to have the chance to do. So I think for me, I think it's just like upholding this legacy that's there and upholding the structure, but still adding my like Ricardo flair in
yes,
that.
Please.
And like putting myself in this role and seeing what comes out of that. Yeah. And this is my first time performing a work from Crystal. I've done like plenty of workshops and stuff, but nothing of this stature and in this house, which is amazing and terrifying, but also incredible.
Oh, it's gonna be great.
Yeah.
It's gonna be so great.
I'm excited.
I'm excited to see you guys do it.
Also, this is the first time NDT2 has had the opportunity to perform Crystal. So I think also coming with that knowledge, that is a responsibility that comes with that, and to uphold this thing that we can do together.
Sometimes you're getting all here. This isn't, you're not using your legs or your back.
John, will this be the first time you see this piece being performed by different casts? And what is that like for you?
Ah, okay. Yeah, you do. We've talked about this. No, it's not the first time I actually got to see Ballet Flanders do this. And it was, again, just really warming. It was the first time I saw another company do it, because I kept hearing like, oh, this company's doing it, this company's doing it. And I was like, oh, I want to do it again. And actually, I still want to do it again now that you guys are doing it. So no, it was just really nice. It was the music, everything about it, like just watching and being in the audience. And I love the work, and it's my humble beginnings. And just to see other people dance it and see how they what they bring artistically to it, and it's really nice. I mean, you previously said that this is the first time for the second company to dance Crystal, right?
Yeah.
And that you've taken some workshops in the past and whatnot. So I have a question here. How does her work or movement language differ from other choreographies that you've danced so far?
I think Crystal requires a different type of rawness in her movement. I think there's more human connection to it than what I've done previously in school and here. Specifically, we talk a lot about the hands and how there's tension in the hands, but there's like weighted, like you're holding someone's head. The image that I have is like I'm holding my little brother's head, and what that means for me is like I'm caressing it, but still there's like weight there. I think the physicality of it is natural, but I think mentally is where the switch comes from and how I approach the movement. And it's not as like you're busting out this like huge physical thing. You're really just trying to establish this human connection to movement and the rawness and the willingness to move, which is different from what I've experienced here and other choreographies.
Yeah. I agree. I think there's a humanity to her language and her imagery that not all reps and dance creations have naturally put into the work. You know, such a thing about the quality of movement and direction of eye and everything like that. But somehow she also brings it back to the sensitivity just humanity.
Yeah. Ooh, this is a good question. Do you have any advice for me performing this role? And what were some of the surprises in giving shape to this role?
I mean, I'd say it's gonna keep developing and developing the more you get to do it. And it took me time to really settle into it. And I think it'll be the same. I would say that there needs to be enough risk to justify the rescue. It's all about, like you said, it's all about support and rescue and the sensitivity and the space between and everything like that. And for me, when I watch this piece, it's that on edge, like, she's gonna make it type thing, you know? So to justify the rescue, there has to be enough risk taken.
I think that also like just encapsulates the whole piece of risking. And I think what Cindy always talks about is like the risk of it all, and like you're always on edge, but you're not on the edge of sense of physicality, but physicality, yes, but this connection between each pair.
Yeah,
but the risk for sure.